back in 52. Lying awake intently tuning in on you. If I was young, it didn't stop you coming through. Hi guys, we're here in New York today and we're at Inbox Awesome. If you don't know Inbox Awesome, don't worry, you're forgiven. It's a new conference here. And we're actually at the Hudson Yards in New York. It's a beautiful location. You can see it's a little overcast outside, but I can tell you things are heating up in here. I'm actually here with Matthew Hartman. And Matthew Hartman is with BetterWorks. And if you don't know BetterWorks, well, you'll soon will. Matthew, you are one of their VCs, if you will. Tell me, how did you find out about this awesome event?
So I've been here for a few years now. Amal, who puts it together, I think always does a very good job not only focusing on email inboxes, but also on kind of pushing the boundaries of what it means to be an inbox, whether it's in all these different communications platforms. So this year I came because one of the things they were talking about was messaging bots.
Yes, messaging bots. We all know those BOTs, people, and that AI that's all happening with our bots and it's all coming into our world. So tell me, you're an entrepreneur yourself. You had a startup that really focused on protecting digital rights for downloads and whatnot. You're now a VC for BetterWorks. Tell me, what do you look for in entrepreneurs since you were an entrepreneur or are an entrepreneur yourself?
Yeah, so we look for a few different things. At BetterWorks, we're very product-focused, and so we look to try the actual products people are building, usually in the social media space, and understand what the kind of that key thing is that they think is true that other people don't think is true, and how that manifests itself in the product that they're building. So usually they have some fundamental insight, and even if it's an early alpha or beta, that there's examples of how their thesis is being put into use in the product that they're building.
Fantastic. So definitely there's going to be a lot of startups here coming to you today with either proof of concept or ideas. Have you met any this morning that have stood out to you that you can speak of?
So I just joined when to watch the panel before me. So I had seen that one of the companies that I know is Shine. They have a really interesting bot that's in the sort of personal coaching almost space. I think they're really interesting. I'm looking forward to some of these people who I've seen the bots already, and then some of them I'm also just getting ready to meet as soon as we're done.
It's so exciting, and definitely it's a hot topic. I'm so glad they're speaking to it. It was first on the panel, guys, for those early birds that could get up in time, right? We need bots to do it for us in the future. That will happen. So tell me, what, you know, when you guys invest in a ton of different startups and whatnot, what are kind of some attributes you look for in entrepreneurs? You can name two that are really important for a startup CEO or founder.
I think one is true dedication to the problem that they want to solve. Ideally, they're going to be working on this company for the next 5 to 10 years. And so having some, whether it's personal experience, a personal story that drove them to solve this problem, or work experience over the last 5 to 10 years, they've been trying to solve this in a big company, maybe they're trying to work on it in a small company. So that's one, is sort of dedication to the problem. And then the second, I would say broadly, is just this resourcefulness and the idea that there's a problem they need to solve. That might be the product problem, that might be the business problem, that might be figuring out how to hire their next hire. And so the ability to just get there, and that's persistence, resourcefulness.
And the vision, the long-term, to scale your business, obviously, as well. So what is it about New York specifically that differentiates it from other areas or locations in regards to the VC ecosystem? What do you think really sets it apart? And what do you think, I guess, VCs are really keen to uptake? What verticals here in New York?
Well, I think one of the big things you mentioned, verticals, that's unique about New York is that there's so many different industries. So you have a ton of media, a ton of fashion, finance, and I think that what you end up with is entrepreneurs coming out of those industries that you can then back to build the next version of those companies that we're at, which I think is pretty different than out west, particularly in Silicon Valley, where a lot of people are sort of very, very tech focused, as opposed to taking technology and applying it to different industries. For us in particular, we are actually much more tech and engineering and consumer product focused, and so we look at the design community that's in New York, and try to find products where, I'll use an example of Giphy, where so much of what they're doing is technology, but it's also a taste in building a brand, and the ability to do that, I think, is uniquely New York.
Absolutely, and it comes with experience. I really like what you say. It is like industry. There's a ton of experience here. Obviously, if you work in New York in an industry, you're working right in the lion's mouth, so to speak. And that's a really important point, that you're coming with experience and then kind of matching with the technology, as opposed to, we have this technology, we know nothing about the industry. How do you navigate that? So talent meets tech people, super important. So two last questions, very important, that we like to use here at Parlez Me. So tell me, who is an entrepreneur? You can name someone here, you can name your father, you can name your partner, whatever. But an entrepreneur that really inspires you in this whole startup world that we're all in.
I mean, there's a whole bunch of entrepreneurs that I look up to for different reasons. I think there are the people who are sort of intellectually pushing the kind of the philosophy of what it means to have human-computer interaction for us to communicate with each other. So that can be anybody from Mark Zuckerberg to somebody who's building a brand new startup here that's extremely product-focused. And then there are entrepreneurs, I think, who are very focused on this business model. Companies that comes to mind that's not an investment for us, but is somebody who I admire, is Dennis from X.AI. Because I think one of the things that he does very well is he marries this sort of philosophical view of how the world should be with creating a product that can be used and monetized today. And that's a rare thing.
There you go. And why aren't you investing in it?
he raised money before
He's
I joined.
Already, okay, yeah, he was off and flying before he could. Okay, no worries. And our last but most important question, people, is if you had to gamble, not endorsing it, but if you were, are you a blackjack, a roulette, or a poker player?
You know, I would say I'm aspirationally poker, but practically blackjack.
Ah, still strategies involved in both those. You didn't say roulette, so you take.
I can't do roulette because then you really have no control. At least you have the illusion of control in blackjack,
yes.
And then I'm just not good enough at poker to sit down with people who are great at it.
At least you put some thought into the decision-making process. Yes, I like that analogy. Well, look, so awesome to meet you. Enjoy this conference. It's so important. Events like this, you can meet so many amazing founders today. We're going to interview a lot of them. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Such a pleasure.